Jake pulling out of the driveway right now. As you can see right now, and my brother's friend Subaru STI hatchback. Pretty nice car. Time to get out of here. Just going to work today, guys. Sunday, I gotta go to work. Alright guys, I don't know if you can notice from the last video, I got a new mount in here today, so that you guys can see a little bit more out the windshield of what's happening. I might try the head mount. I have a head mount as well. That way I give you like a point of view kind of look, and that way maybe I can do some videos of me chirping other drivers, because there's a lot of bad drivers here. Mississauga, Canada, Ontario. Oh man, back in my Subaru WRX. I'm gonna film a walk around of the car later today when I get to work, so you guys can see, you know, what the car is all about, how she looks. I'm probably gonna post both of them up tonight. Guys, let me know if you know anything about that loud whine. I was kind of worried about that initially here, hearing that loud turbo whine. I'm assuming it is the turbo when I'm getting my I don't have a boost leak. My cob access port's telling me that I'm making my boost, my peak boost, which is about 15 PSI for this Subaru WRX. Pretty nice. My buddy's that STI that we saw there when I was leaving my house. That guy's making about 20 PSI. There's a couple cars in the line there. One, two, three cars in the line. I don't think I'm gonna wait. I'm not gonna wait. The car's still pretty clean. It rained all day yesterday, but it's still not bad. You guys, there's Tim Hortons. I'm gonna stop the other window closer to work. I like to drink my coffee when I get to work. You guys are really gonna hear. I'll give it a going on the highway, merging onto the highway. You guys are really hear that turbo whine now. Boys, tell me. I hope this GoPro camera can pick it up. It's pretty loud, louder than a lot of other guys I know. Subarus, but nobody really says that it's a problem, I guess. I have a warranty, so even if it is a problem, they fix it for free, so, you know, I can't complain, but if it is a problem, I want to find out what it is, or if it isn't a problem, I want to find out what it is, because every time I step on the gas, it bothers me a little bit, just thinking that there might be something wrong. But hey, car's still acting fine, driving nice, beautiful. I actually kind of have a little bit of low tire. I should fill that up. We'll probably see that later on. There is a little bit I'm gonna have to let go. There you go, full throttle, third gear, boom, boost, 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 boost. near one, that big mall in Mississauga is. If anybody's from around this area, they know exactly what it is. It's just a giant square. This is pretty much like the downtown Mississauga, essentially. All the buildings, as you can kind of see. Hopefully you can see, I'm not too sure. It's off to the right a little bit. All the buildings, all the mall, the big mall, city center where, like, you know, the mayor is. Kind of see a little bit of that. Man, it's nice over here. It's pretty nice. It's not too bad, you know. They always do those DUI checkpoints right here on this road right off the highway to get to the mall, I guess. There's all the clubs and the bars and stuff there. Drinking and driving. I know a couple buddies got those DUIs, man. They're not fun. Not something good you want. He wasn't even driving, he passed out in his truck, he threw his keys in the cab with him, and cop nailed him for a DUI, man. Wasn't even planning on driving, which sucks, you know. Like, we had another buddy who was driving that night, and just because buddy passed out in his truck wasn't feeling too good, he got a DUI, man. So it's not fun, it sucks. He ended up spending like $10,000 in lawyer fees. $10,000 in lawyer fees to get it off, man. Not fun. Not fun if you ask me. It's unfortunate for him. Too bad he hasn't learned from it yet. Still doing stupid shit all the time. It's not fun. Man, I hate these Fords. It's like a half a pickup truck. Here's my exit. They're just building all these bus terminal things right now for, like, they literally built an extra highway because the traffic is so bad, just for buses and emergency vehicles, stuff like that, transit, so that they can get on time. Traffic in this area is so bad. Shift, let my engine do the braking. Goes from a 100 to a 60 over here, still kind of going 80. I'll downshift down to third gear. Let my car slow down a little bit. I'll upshift back up to fourth. Boom, boom, 70. It's not too bad. In Canada, man, at least, I don't want to say Canada in general, but here where we live in this greater Toronto area, you're pretty golden going 10 over the speed limit. Nobody's going to give you a hassle, nobody's going to give you a hard time. I have not gotten the ticket once, and I usually stick to the 10 above the speed limit kind of thing, and I haven't been bothered, even driving the Subaru, man. Like, cops kind of pick on these cars, just because, like, big hood scoop, and usually they're really loud. Even in my old car, the Acura RSX, like, Hondas, they really pick on the Hondas because there's a lot of Honda guys here in this area. Look at that BMW's Plastic, man. I had a Plastic car. I'm gonna share that experience with you guys another time. I'll show you some pictures of it. It was not good, man. The paint underneath, like, it had a bunch of rust on it when I bought the car, so I fixed up a lot of the rust. And I ended up paint batching it. But the paint match was so bad that, like, it wasn't the same color. So the whole fender was just a different color. And it pissed me off to the point where I just said, fuck it, I'm going to Plasti-Dip it. I did it in my garage, ordered the Plasti-Dip, ended up costing me $250 for all the Plasti-Dip and shit. I did it. I used my dad's, like, Wagner Pro paint gun. There's one of my jobs right now, Tompkin. I work there as well for the city, but I'm not going there today. Yeah. So I ended up plastic-dipping my RSX white, and it looked great for, like, fuck, 2 weeks maybe? I started getting this black exhaust soot from my car and from my exhaust on the back of my car, and it got even worse and worse. And every time somebody touched my car with dirty hands, it left stains, and it was just not pretty. Like, I, at the end of it, I was just so lazy, I didn't even want to peel the plastic dip. I ended up just selling the car with it on, and that was it. And you know what, man? Yeah, I guess. I always used to say, good from far, far from good. It was good from far, far from good. I'm just gonna stop and grab Timmy's right quick. You won't see any of this, I'll edit all this shit out. But, either way, let's see if anybody waves to us. If anybody does anything stupid while I'm inside, seeing the GoPro hanging from my thing, it'll be kind of fun. I guess we'll see it on the camera, and if there's anything, then I'll leave it in the video. Alright guys, that was all of 10 seconds. I might even just leave that. I won't leave that in the video for you guys, don't worry. Alright, we're back guys. Getting in the car, car started up. Alright, let's get going. Off to work.
Snow beast.
to and you got no idea what you're doing, that's today for me, man. I'm going there and I don't know where I'm, like, what I'm doing, what the game plan is. I work at a hockey arena. I'm a Zamboni driver. So I know what I'm doing, but we have, like, all kinds of events and stuff in my workplace. We have, like, the Raptors 905, the Development League, and the Mississauga Steelheads, which is, like, the Ontario Hockey League team. So, you know, sometimes I have to work those events and stuff as a supervisor. I hope today is just a regular, easy day right after Christmas. No lease rentals or anything. Basic stuff. Very easy, hopefully. I won't have to, never mind. I guess I'm just going to go around this truck. Just in my way here. Four ways on and stuff. Oh, looks like he was kind of broken down or something. He had his engine hood open. Engine exposed. Maybe something's going on there. Turn into my workplace here. Hershey's Port Zone. I'm here. Looks like there's quite a few people here. I don't know why. There might be games. It is Sunday. Oh my god, this place is packed. Shit. I guess it's a regular work day for me. I was hoping, you know, first day back after the holidays. Nice, relaxing, easy day. I guess not. Oh, here we are, guys. We're at work, man. This is pretty much the end of this vlog. I might continue this up after work. We'll see what happens, really, how I'm feeling. I'm gonna do a video about a walk around my car today at some point. And then I'll post that up with this one. Not in this same video, but in another video, so you guys can kind of see how my car is right now before I do, really. I've done a few mods to it. The taillight overlays were one of my favorites that I wanted to get done. The stock taillights on these WXs aren't the nicest, in my opinion. But once you add those little taillight overlays, man, beautiful, 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 beautiful. All right, guys. That's it, I'm at work, so see you guys later. Peace.